Hello. If you're working on modern day microservices, you know that observability is key component. We need to observe microservices in distributed environment. We cannot rely on traditional methods of looking at old attributes. We have to have a very robust way of monitoring our applications which are running in a highly scalable environment. One such tool which is used quite common when it comes to microservices and when we want to implement observability for our applications is Prometheus. Prometheus is used for collecting metrics. It gives us insights into what is happening in our environment, and we can use these metrics to derive various observations and to come to conclusions. In this video, we are going to see how to deploy Prometheus onto our Kubernetes cluster using Helm. Helm is a package manager for Kubernetes, and all the things which are required for setting up a Prometheus environment or Prometheus related services in our Kubernetes cluster will be deployed using Helm. My name is Nilesh. Let's get started. The first thing we have to do is to look for what we call as a repository when it comes to Helm. I'm going to run this command which says Helm search repo Prometheus, and there are different repositories which gives us access to Prometheus related services or Prometheus related objects which are required for deploying on our Kubernetes cluster. There is things which are coming from Azure Marketplace like the Kube Prometheus. There is a Prometheus operator. There is Wavefront Prometheus storage. There is Kube Prometheus from Bitnami and so on and so forth. We can look at this from the popularity of different charts which are available in the public for Prometheus. A chart is like a template. It's a collection of all the resources like the deployment, services, config maps, secrets, anything that is required for deploying the application on Kubernetes. So we are going to use one of the chart here or one of the repository here, which is coming from the community. It is called Prometheus Community, which has built a Helm chart for deploying the complete Prometheus stack onto Kubernetes. This consists of the Prometheus itself, the objects or the services required for running Prometheus. It also comes with what is called as the exporters for Kubernetes. And it also has the visualization piece tied together by having Grafana. And it by default creates a data source in Grafana for Prometheus. So we have certain dashboards created as part of this Prometheus Kube Stack or Kube Prometheus Stack, which is once it is installed, we will have a complete solution which scrapes our Kubernetes cluster. It collects metrics from our Kubernetes cluster, like the API metrics, the node exporter from different nodes, and it pushes it onto Prometheus database, and from there it also visualizes it using some default dashboards. So this dashboard is available in Grafana. I've run this command to upgrade or install Prometheus. If it exists, it would try to upgrade. If it doesn't exist, it will install the Prometheus. The name of the release that we are using here is Prometheus, and the chart that we are going to use is coming from Prometheus-community repository, and the specific chart is Kube Prometheus Stack. We are using the wait flag here to wait for the installation to complete before we start accessing the services. So once the installation is complete, we will see that a complete stack of services is installed as part of this Helm command. That is the beauty of Helm. If we were to do this manually ourselves, we will have to apply a lot of manifest files, which can be done, obviously. There is no harm in doing this, but it requires a lot of knowledge about how Prometheus works internally. And sometimes we don't really need all that. All that we need is the ability to deploy a third-party application or third-party service onto our Kubernetes cluster and start using it with a very minimal knowledge. That is what I'm going to do here. I don't intend to change any of the default settings in this case. We are going to use whatever default settings are part of the Kube Prometheus stack, and we are deploying it onto our Kubernetes cluster. And then we can see that the Prometheus has been installed, and we also get a command here to check the status, what is running. we can run this kubectl namespace default and get pods command to see what are the pods which are running as part of this, and we specify or we filter the pods which have the label release equal to Prometheus. It created five different pods here. First one is for the Prometheus operator. The other one is for kube state matrix, which collects matrix from our Kubernetes cluster and publishes it to the Prometheus database. And then we have three node exporters. Because I have a three node Kubernetes cluster here, there is a daemon set which is running, which exports the node related matrix or the Kubernetes node matrix and transfers it or publishes it to the Prometheus. Now with Prometheus installed, we can also look at the workload running, or we can visualize what did happen as part of our Helm install using the Lens user interface or Lens IDE. Here, if I go into the workloads, we can see the pods. There are various pods which are running, and the ones which are running with the prefix as Prometheus are the ones created by the Helm chart. So we have the Prometheus Grafana pod created for the Grafana user interface or running Grafana. Then we have the operator, we have the kube state matrix, we have kube Prometheus. This is a stateful set because it has zero in the end. And then we have the node exporters. Same way, if we go into the config maps, we might find some config map created. In fact, there are so many. We can see the Prometheus Grafana, Prometheus config dashboard, alert manager, API server. All these different config maps were also created as part of the Helm install or Helm upgrade with install as the flag. We also have alert manager and Prometheus related secrets which are coming here. Let's go into the services and see what are the services which were exposed as part of Prometheus. So Prometheus Grafana is one of the services which is exposed on port 80. We will be referring to this, or we will do a port forward here. Lens has this very useful way of exporting or doing a port forwarding. I can click on this link and it will take me to a port. Let's stop the existing port forwarding and then try to do it once again on port 80. So when I click here, it will take me to the Prometheus Grafana service and it will do a port forwarding and it will open it in the browser for me. Looks like there is some problem. Let's do it once again. We remove the existing port forwarding. We do have the service running, the Prometheus Grafana. Maybe it's just a matter of refresh or intermittent issue. Let's go into priority class and come back to services here. Then we go back to Prometheus Grafana and do a forward. And let's say we want to do a port forwarding on 80 and we want to open it in the browser. So our local port 80 will be now port forwarding to 80 port on the Kubernetes cluster. And we can see the Grafana page coming up here and asking us for the login. Now there is a default login which is created, which we can again get from the secrets. And there would be a secret for connecting to Grafana. So if we go into the Prometheus Grafana secret and we look at the admin user, this is the admin or named as admin, and the password is prom operator. So we'll use this to connect to the Grafana UI. I did a video recently about how to use the Lens ID to interact with things like the secrets. Okay. When we input that password, we use the admin as the username and the admin password as prom hyphen operator. That's the default password which is created and put as a secret. We are able to log into the Grafana UI. And as part of the Kube Stack Prometheus installation using the Helm chart, we also have the data source created as a default data source. So if you go into the connections here and we navigate to data sources, we will see that the alert manager and Prometheus are set as the existing data sources, and the alert manager is running on 9093 port. This is used for sending alerts, which is one of the component of Prometheus, or one of the supplement for Prometheus for sending alerts. And there is the Prometheus itself, which is running on port 9090. With this, we can now go back to our dashboards. And again, part of the Kube Stack Prometheus also involves creating a default dashboards. So when we go into the general category of dashboards, we will see that there are some default dashboards created for Alert Manager, Core DNS, Grafana Overview, API Server. Let's go into one of this, like let's say we go into the compute resources and pods, and we look at the pod related metrics. And here we can see that the default data source is marked as default, which is Prometheus. So the data is being pulled from Prometheus here. The namespace is default, so we can filter which namespace we want to filter the results for. And then there are various pods which are running on this inside this namespace. So we can use one of these to find out what is the resource usage, like the CPU usage, the CPU throttling, the quota, and all this visualization is created as part of that Kube Stack Prometheus. Let me show you one more thing before we go back and look at how to delete this. So let's look at the workload in terms of the compute resources, or rather we were looking at the pod. Let's look at something different, like in terms of the node exporter. Let's look at the node metrics or nodes. And here we can see that the memory usage currently is at 33.6, and we can also find out the disk usage, the network usage on different nodes. We have three nodes, so we can filter these nodes. Currently we were looking at .04 or .4. Let's look at .5, and it shows us the metrics related to that, or information related to that particular node. So this way we can see that using the chart, or using the Helm chart related to Kube Prometheus Stack, we get the complete stack of services related to Prometheus, like the Alert Manager, the Prometheus, we get Grafana UI, and all that is integrated as well. It makes our life very easy for installing all these services using one single command, which is Helm upgrade. And in summary, we were able to do this by running maybe three commands. First one was to add the repository to the Prometheus community. If it was not part of our charts, or locally we didn't have this, we had a reference to this Prometheus community chart. Then we run the Helm repo update command to update the contents of the charts locally on our laptop. And finally, we run the Helm install or Helm upgrade command to apply this chart to the Kubernetes cluster. The last thing I want to show is how easy it is to uninstall. Let's say I don't want to continue with this. I've done whatever testing I had to do. Usually once you install observability solution like Prometheus, you would use it for quite a long period of time. But in case you want to delete this, the command is again very simple. We run the Helm uninstall and the release name. In this case, we created a release with the name Prometheus. So we will use the same name to uninstall the components which were installed. With Helm uninstall and Prometheus as the name of the release name, everything that got installed as part of the installation would be reverted back, and we would have our Kubernetes cluster back in the state where it was before we applied Prometheus. With that, we have come to the end of this video. I hope you found this useful. I've done similar videos with regards to Helm on this channel. Do look out for that. If you need more information about how to install Helm charts using Lens as the visual way, or the Kubernetes IDE way without having to install the Helm CLI on your laptop, I also did a video on how to use Helm to install RabbitMQ, and there are other videos on this channel. So I hope you found this useful. In case you like this, please hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, And let me know in the comments what other features or what other things you would like me to share in the upcoming videos. Thanks once again. Until next time, code with passion and strive for excellence.